Hello and welcome back everyone. So in this video we are going to talk about the query function and closures also. So first let's talk about the closures, and I will be talking about one of the basic example which everybody talks about. Okay, so here I have a function b, function add1, and it is taking b as an argument. And what it is doing, okay, now what I'm returning from this function is function b. This is what I'm returning, right? This is the very basic example, and this will explain everything about the closures. Okay, so let's talk about calling add1 method by passing 2. Okay, now let's do console.dir on to x, because x is representing another function, because add function is returning another function and doing the calculation a plus b. So while calling add, what we will get another function, and if you see there are three scope in that function. First is a global scope. Okay, so in this closure scope you can see a2 is stored. So what is the closure? First of all, a closure is a persistence mechanism in JavaScript using which the inner functions can access the values which are available in the outer function. And here in this case, the outer function has already returned the value 2, right? The outer function has already returned, but the value of the parameter is still there in the closure of the inner function. So inner function is keeping the value 2 inside the closure of the inner function because it is accessible. This add1 function can access the values defined in the immediate scope, right? Because you are calling add by passing 2, and this function is what it is returning. It is returning add1 function, and add1's immediate outer scope is the add function, right? So it can access the values which are defined in the add function. And add function is already returned, but that value is persisted inside the closure of the add1 function. You can see this is the add1 function, add1 function's scope. There is a closure, and inside the closure we are having 2. Now this x can again be called, right, with some value 6. You are getting the sum, right? Now you are calling this function again and passing some value. So you are passing b, so it will return a plus b. So this is one of the good example which people use to explain the closure, right? So what is happening in the closure example here? Let me write it in the different way. So either you can also write it in this way, it will give you 30, right? Similarly, if you can have one more nested function where you are accepting the argument c and returning a plus b plus c. So when you are actually just calling add with the argument 7, you are actually doing a partial invocation of the function, because that function again returning another function. So either you assign this function to something else and I call it again by passing some other argument, then you will get the value, right? So this is a very basic example of closure. When you are calling add 7, 7 is being stored inside the closure of the inner function scope, and whenever you are calling that function again, then it is calculating 7 plus 3 and giving you the 10. But what this is called, this is called a partial invocation and closures. Sorry, query function is built on top of the closures. So this is the basic example, right? There can be one more example where you might be returning. So function this, right? Now you can have another function add 2, and you are passing c as an argument, and what this function is giving you, a plus b plus c, and from this function you are actually returning add 2, right? So add 1 is return, add 2 is returning add 1. Let me just check the indentation and all. Okay, So this is my add1 function, which will be returning add2 function, and add2 function is this, right? So you can call this for a1 equal to add2, and if you do the console.dir, a1 has a 3 scope, and inside the closure you can see a2 is being persisted, right? So similarly, you can again just call this either a partial invocation, or you can just trigger call this like this, right? So a1 will give you the 10. So what it is, this is actually the partial invocation, and you are actually keep calling this. Now a1 again pass the second argument, assign it to or a2, sorry. Now again, and again call this a2 with passing some another value, right? Okay, I did something wrong. This is a2. So a1, a2, yeah, right? So this is how the chaining is happening, right? So we are actually partially invoking the first, then values are being stored in the closure of the inner function, then again we are calling the outer inner functions. If there is further inner function, those values are being stored in the closures of those, right? So this is how the curry functions and the closures works, right? You are actually keep calling this function. So whenever you are calling the add function, this is actually returning this function, which is a partial invocation. You again need to call add1, then you again need to call add2. This is called the concept of currying in JavaScript.